Welcome to Dragon's Den. The financial climate remains uncertain, but here in the Den, five of Britain's sharpest business brains are still ready and willing to plough their personal cash into the right business idea. And our first entrepreneurial duo to make a pitch today think they've devised an ingenious solution to an irksome old problem. Will they tempt the dragons to invest?
Hello everybody, my name's Bob, my partner Steve. We've got something wonderful that we want you to love because it's fantastic. We're introducing the Easy Lift Drain to you. Many drains will not come out of the ground. They jam, they get corroded in, and they're an awful problem. This drain, you put two screws in, you screw down and it lifts on the bottom frame. So consequently, the surrounding ground stays the same, doesn't move. And you can see it's the minimum of effort, not difficult. You lower one end down on a pair of casters and you can swing it round and you do the repair. And look at the saving. Utility companies sending out two men to lift a drain. When you need a repair at home, you can literally do this yourself. We have one of the top builders merchants in the country selling it for us. We think we could go worldwide. So let the drain take the strain. Thank you very much.
An exuberant pitch from Bob Cave and Steve Parsons, who are seeking a £100,000 investment in return for a 25% stake in their company. But Bob's unbridled enthusiasm for his product has left Peter Jones at a loss for words.
Bob, is there something wrong with you?
Why?
Because you got so excited about this drain cover lift.
Well, I could be boring, couldn't I? But I think we've got something special.
Bob, it's just a drain spinny thing, isn't it?
Well, if it was that, why we've painted it? Isn't it a fantastic idea?
Listen, people paint a lot of things. It doesn't mean that they're great things.
How come we're selling them?
Now are you talking? Now you're talking, Bobster.
How come the biggest building merchants in England?
So, Bob, just take a deep breath. You've done your pitch.
Sure.
You've done quite well.
Thank you.
You've sold some. That's the bit that got me. So, tell me how it's selling at the moment.
Well, let's say to you it's in its infancy. This is really new. We've not been going years.
I've got a funny feeling you might say that. But I just want to know how many have you sold?
60.
60?
Yeah.
OK. And how many have you made?
60.
OK. And who have you sold them to?
Travis Perkins.
And how many have they sold?
They've sold about 20.
And how long have they had them?
4 months.
4 months they've sold 20?
Yes. We're looking at something that could go worldwide.
Bob's putting up a passionate defence, but there's something about the claims he's making for his product that's troubling Kelly Hoppen.
I build houses all over the world, and whenever you're going to put a drain in, you can put tiles on the top, you can put tarmac on the top, anything, because when you lift it out, you don't have to then destroy everything around the perimeter. So that you haven't created something new there.
No, we have, because when you lift it out...
But I see it being done all the time.
No, yes, but if you lift it out when it's new, yes, you can lift it, because it's got no, it's not fretted into the frame. You do one after 2 years, the frame round it will come up and you'll see all the bricks move.
I've got a drain at home.
Yes.
That I literally put this steel rod into the drain, turn sideways, unlocks, I lift it up.
What weight is that?
Well, it's not that heavy.
What weight? This weighs 64 kilos. You're not supposed to lift over 25 kilos. So this is fantastic. You're not going to have a bad back. Look what it does to help people.
We know the health and safety lifting guidelines, and this is the only drain that's got a one-man lifting system that can remove that quite easily with no effort at all. I can do that in about two minutes, 35 seconds. And that's putting it...
Steve, you look shattered.
It's been a long day. I can do that in 2 minutes, 35 seconds. And for recessed manhole covers, can take a lot longer.
I've opened drains that size before on my own, with two keys lifted up. Not a problem.
That's correct, but...
If you did that weigh over 25 kilos...
Yeah.
Then you're not doing right. You're going to hurt your back.
How long does a drain cover last? 120 years?
Yeah, it could do, yeah.
So 120 years, every drain cover may have been replaced by yours if everyone started today.
If that happened, we'd be rich men.
We'd be dead as well.
No, we wouldn't.
Piers Linney may have failed to dent Bob's optimism, but has Kelly Hoppen spotted something about his product that could dent a potential investment?
I've come to you, I've got existing drains,
yes,
and I want to buy off you the parts to change the existing drains I've got. Is that possible?
It could be for existing when the other drain manufacturers take the mechanism on.
So I have to buy a whole new system?
This is development. We've gone a long way in a short time. We're adding this into the market. How many new drains are fitted every week in this country?
Why are you looking at me?
Because you might know.
Well, I actually know how many drains are fitted. Mm. I don't.
No, thousands. We've got...
No, sorry. I'm not letting you get away with that. How many drains are fitted in the UK this
Steve,
each year?
How many? We've done the research.
There's approximately... 40,000 external domestic drains. All in all, the commercial side as well, we're talking about probably hundreds of thousands of recess covers that go in per year, yeah. So our business model is for both markets.
How much of the market do you think in the first year you're going to be able to gain?
Well, as we go in, we'd hope 5 to 10%.
Sorry, in your first year, you're going to get 5 to 10% of the sales are going to...
From going full flow with marketing and assistance, we think we can sell in the region of 3,000 to 4,000 units per annum.
Bob, you don't need marketing. If you're in with the biggest building merchant,
yeah,
and he's already bought 20, and he finds how great they are, he'll come back another 100. You don't need marketing. You just need him to buy them.
How much is a normal recessed drain cover of that size?
We think it's around about £35 to £42.
So the premium on yours is about £16?
Yes.
Because of the lift?
Yes, because of that system.
I've seen in my profession for the last 9 years contractors having to go back to site to destroy the whole thing to put another one in. So these contractors will prefer to buy this because it saves them money.
The trouble is, most people don't place the reasons that you're talking about up front. If they're going to lose a contract because their price is wrong, trust me, they're going to put the original drains in. This will not be bought by anybody unless they are prepared to pay a premium. So I'm sorry, I won't be investing. I'm out.
A dubious Deborah Meaden has declined the opportunity to invest. Will Duncan Bannatyne be any more willing to make Bob and Steve an offer?
How much money have you invested in this, Steve?
My redundancy money has gone into it.
How much?
Around about sort of 15,000.
15,000?
Yeah.
Yeah, how much have you put in, Bob?
Around 5,000 plus. My company has carried a lot of costs to develop it.
I just think the money you both put into this is just money down the drain. It's just not a viable project. So for that reason, I'm out.
OK.
My issue with this is that you need to change the manhole cover industry, the drain industry, which is great. Maybe you will, but it might take 100 years to replace all the drains out there where they can apply your system. And I haven't got 100 years to wait. I'm looking to invest, not generate a legacy for those that come after me. But whatever you've invented here isn't a business, so I'm out.
OK, thank you.
Three dragons have bowed out. Now it's time for Kelly Hoppen to have her say.
I build multi-million pound homes all over the world, and the end result is the most important. So to have something that I know is not going to destroy something that I've designed and my builders have built at the end is music to my ears. But I don't know commercially how you can make this work in terms of existing drains. So I think go away, try and figure out some way that you can adapt the idea and rework how you're going to actually get this to market and sell it. But I'm not going to invest, so I'm afraid I'm out.
Okay,
but good
thank
luck.
You.
I think it is a great, neat invention, and if you can find a way to retrofit this, I think that you will sell a lot. I wouldn't have invested in it because, frankly, I'd rather paint my own toenails. I find it just... I'm just not interested in it. I say good luck to you, I'm not going to invest, and I'm out.
See
you. Thank you, guys.
The drain might be taking the strain, but sadly for Bob and Steve, they won't be taking any of the dragon's hard-earned cash.
Oh, well.
We did the best, didn't we?
We hope, but the good thing about it is they liked it.
If you look at both of us, we've had a go. A lot of people just stand there and do nothing. And we've done our bit. And my old mate, Mr. Brilliant.
Yeah.